So we've got the loop there. Obviously they're singles, so I'm just gonna cut down the middle. And they're both a bit too long, so yes, I'm wasting a bit. So I'm just gonna trim them down so they're all the same size. And then I'm gonna just strip them back. Now, I'm only gonna strip them back partly, just like this. So I'm only doing each one, partially stripping them. And hopefully that'll become apparent in a second. That just makes it so when I twist them up, it's easier to grab hold of the end there to start twisting, rather than actually grabbing hold of the cable. And then I can just cut it to size. I'm not doubling these back because there's not enough space in the back of the socket. And now you can see that's nice and neat. So I'll just do the rest of them. Makes it so much quicker. When you cut them, I always just give them one more twist, because sometimes when you cut through, it just splays them open slightly. Hasn't done really there, but just through habit, just twist it up one more time. And this just makes them so much, it makes the job neat. So many times you go to a socket with singles on and they've not been doubled up, they've not been twisted up. And I just think it looks untidy. There you have it, six cables twisted up. So I take the socket and just untwist, unscrew the screws. These are the click sockets. I think they're the best sockets you can buy. They're much better than, they're really good quality sockets. So take your pairs. There's my two live or line conductors, and push them in. So there's no copper exposed. And give them an extra push so everything is just pushed in nice and neatly. And hold it down with my thumb. Now I won't tighten them up too tight just yet. And just twisting them in. And then both of the CPCs, generally I'd put them both in one of the earthing terminals together. So that's what they look like now. There's no exposed copper. Oh no, apologies, there is slightly on that one. It's no good. Push it back in. That's better. Okay, so that's all, they're all in. That's nice and neat. Next one is to put a fly lead to the back of the box. So again, twist it up, and these ones double back. They can just go in nicely on the back. I'm not doing that as well as what I should. Okay, there you have it. You've got your main CPCs, you've got your line, and you've got your neutral, and then the fly lid.